Anybody ready for Stump the Bump trivia? Oh,
yes, let's go.
I am.
Waiting.
Winner of the tournament earns the right to take on our current Stump the Bump trivia champion, Mike Brown, and a chance to win two tickets to a future live event and a signed Shawn Michaels winged eagle HBK signature title. So really big prizes. There's a lot at stake, but Mike Brown, he has a lot to say about this. So let's see what he said before we kick this thing off.
Now, I'm not going to lie, I'm going to be completely honest. I'm not impressed with who WWE picked for this contest. What's that one guy's name who's in it?
Kmart or something?
No, I think it's like Zone, Discovery Zone, DZ. Oh, you know what, DZ? You said that little fact about DDP at WrestleMania 6. You know how easy that question is? That's like saying Mike Brown has red hair. Everybody knows that. And what's the other guy's name? Scott Gatta? Oh. What, Scott Gatta rip off my video I made last year? Or, you know what it is? It's Scott Gatta lose to Mike Brown.
The trash talk has been plentiful. I want to start with one of my early favorites, the K-Zone, bringing him up right here. And the K-Zone basically says, through no uncertain terms, that he is taking the first round, no question. Now, he's obviously not facing Mike Brown in the first round, but Mike Brown had his own thoughts on that, and really just with a sick burn here, K-Zone, more like the O-Zone, but then since this is a sports entertainment trivia contest with one of the deepest cuts you can have, who remembers the Big O?
All right, as we see, the trash talk has already begun, as it should, because there's a lot on the line here. So let's get started. You guys will have 30 seconds to answer these rapid-fire questions. The clock will start after the first question is read. Contestants can pass on a question, and the contestant with the most points will earn a one-point advantage and go first in round two.
True or false, every women's Money in the Bank cash-in has been successful.
True.
Who was the first ever inductee into the WWE
Andre
Hall
the
of
Giant.
Fame?
Andre
who
the Giant.
Who has the longest SmackDown Women's Championship reign?
Bayley.
Who is the youngest championship holder in WWE history?
Renee Dupree.
Who did Mickie James defeat to win her first WWE Women's Championship?
Trish Stratus.
Who holds the record for most appearances in the Royal Rumble match?
Kane.
Time's up. How'd you feel?
I feel good.
You got 5 correct answers, though. Yeah. Good job. All right. So 5 is the number for Alex to beat.
True or false? King Corbin has won the Money in the Bank briefcase.
True.
Who is the only person to hold the NXT Championship and the NXT North American Championship at the same
Keith
time?
Keith Lee.
Who did The Miz defeat to win his first WWE Championship?
Randy Orton.
Which superstar did Chyna eliminate in her Royal Rumble match?
Chris Jericho.
Ric Flair and Triple H are the only superstars to win the WWE Championship in this match type?
Royal Rumble.
Who did Goldberg defeat in his first WWE? We will not get that one in. Good job, though, bud.
All right. Let's see. How many did he get? Let's see. 4. Okay. That's okay. But that means you're still going, but Scott won. That means Scott is going to be starting on this next round. This is going to be a head-to-head round, and throughout the tournament, we're going to be asking, with the head-to-head rounds, we're going to be asking specific questions about a specific WWE topic or event. In this head-to-head round, specific topic is women's championships. And here are the rules. Each contestant will receive a maximum of 5 questions. Each correct answer earns 1 point. The contestant with the most points at the end of the round advances. Here we go.
Oof, I'm nervous.
I'm nervous as well. Whew. Okay, so again, Scott is going to be going first here. Question number 1. Who was the first ever SmackDown Women's Championship? Champion.
Becky Lynch.
Correct. All right, all right, we're at 2-0. Okay, next. Who were the first WWE Women's Tag Team Champions? This is for Alex.
Sasha and Bayley.
Correct. All right. Who has... Yeah, Scott, back to you. Who has held the SmackDown Women's Championship the most times?
Charlotte Flair.
Good job. All right, we're at 3-1. Okay. Who has held the Raw Women's Championship the most times?
Charlotte Flair.
That is incorrect. That answer would be Sasha Banks. Okay. What event did Trish Stratus win her first WWE Women's Championship?
The 2001 Survivor Series.
Wow! Good job. We're up 4-1. All right. Who did Beth Phoenix defeat to win her first WWE Women's Championship?
Candice Michelle.
You got it. You're still in this,
Candice
buddy.
Michelle.
All right. Yes, this is it. If you get this right, it's all over. How many Japanese-born women have held singles titles in WWE?
I'm going to say 3.
That is incorrect. It is 4. All right. We're still going here. What WWE title has Mickie James held the most times?
The Women's Championship.
That is correct. We're at 4-3. Oh, my gosh. Oh, I'm getting so nervous. All right. How many NXT UK Women's Champions have there been?
4.
It's 3. Oh, what event did Lita win her last WWE Women's Championship?
Survivor Series 2006.
That is incorrect, which makes Scott the winner.
Wow, what a battle.
It was Cyber Sunday.
See, I'm like a peacock, and they're finally going to let me fly, Captain. And it doesn't matter if I'm facing Horton. Here's a who. It doesn't matter if I'm facing Mike Brown, Mike Green, Mike White, Mike Yellow, Mike Gray, Mike Purple.
Good luck to everybody in the competition. Let's have fun. And but we all know, I mean, I'm going to win.
My man, yeah. Billy Horton, what's going on, baby?
Welcome, Billy.
Oh, this is a dream come true, guys. To get that name graphic. I got a name graphic. Oh, my gosh.
True or false, Kevin Owens won the Universal Championship at SummerSlam.
False.
Who is the only person to cash in Money in the Bank at WrestleMania?
Seth Rollins.
Who was the first entry into the Royal Rumble match in 1988?
Pass.
How many times have Edge and Christian won the Tag Team Championships together?
9 times.
Who holds the record for the longest time spent in a WWE ring in a single match?
Daniel Bryan.
Who is the only superstar to win a title from... And... 3 correct answers there. Okay. There you go, Jordan.
Okay. Yeah, Ryan, brother. Billy Horton's up next, brother.
All right, Billy, wishing you a lot of luck. Again, the clock will begin after I finish my first question. We are just milking this for maximum pressure. Just kidding. We wish you a lot of luck, man. Good luck. Here we go. Clock will start at the completion of this first question. Here we go. True or false? Right. Jeff Hardy is a WWE Grand Slam champion.
False.
At what event did John Cena win his 16th world championship?
Royal Rumble.
Who won the first Elimination Chamber match?
Shawn Michaels.
Who was the first superstar to become a 2-time NXT Women's Champion?
Pass.
What year was the last WWE No Way Out event held?
2008.
Who was the first person to successfully capture the WWE? We will not get that one in. Good job, bud.
Ooh. Darn.
Okay.
They're not easy.
No, that was in 09. No, it was 12.
Wow, move on.
Okay, gentlemen. Listen, it's not over. Both you guys are both still in it. This is amazing, though. Jordan will have first. He has a point going into this round. All right, Jordan. First question to you, brother. Who was the first Universal Champion?
Finn Balor.
Correct. Now, Billy, who is the longest reigning Universal Champion?
Brock Lesnar.
Correct. Right. Well, okay. It's two one right now. This is amazing. Who defeated Kevin Owens for the Universal Championship, Jordan?
Goldberg.
Correct. Wow. 3-1. Okay. Now to Billy. Who was the only person to defeat Brock Lesnar for the Universal Championship?
Braun Strowman.
Incorrect. Oh, wow. Okay. Still 3-1. The Universal Championship has changed hands in how many WrestleManias?
Twice.
No, incorrect. How many times has the Universal Championship changed hands outside of the United States?
Zero.
Wow, that is not correct. It's still 3-1. Jordan, next question. What type of match was the Universal Championship defended in at SummerSlam 2017? This is for the game. This is for the win.
Steel cage.
Incorrect. Who challenged Brock Lesnar for the Universal Championship at WWE Great Balls of Fire 2017?
Braun Strowman.
Incorrect. Jordan Rivera has moved on. Man. It is about 3-1. Jordan Rivera is victorious with a strong, strong, strong game, guys.
Good game, man. Jordan.
Wow. Absolutely unbelievable.
Scott got it. Made it clear that he is living in Mike Brown's head rent-free. I think I said that the correct way. Yeah, Devin, I felt the same way. We're going to come over here because Mike Brown was none too pleased with this, guys, and comes back with that he's been studying at 2 a.m., studying such things as, I don't know, Justin Credible's WWE run, Power and Glory, and Haku. Shout-outs to Haku.
Haku, baby.
Shout-outs to Haku.
Thanks so much, Ryan. We all love some good trash talking. Now, are you ready for Stump the Bump?
All right. Ballad ready as pick and be.
Come to you, Buzzard. First question. True or false? The Undertaker entered second for his match with Shawn Michaels at WrestleMania 25.
False.
Who is the only superstar to defeat Finn Balor in demon form?
Pass.
Name the first woman to be a two-time WWE 24/7 champion.
Carmella.
How many superstars were involved in the inaugural championships? All right. Mike, you got one right. It's okay. Okay. So right. Now we're going to be going. Oh, we got HJZ coming up next. And Ryan, you're going to take this one away.
All right, HJZ, the first round score here to beat is 1. The clock will begin at the completion of the first question. Before we start up here, just want to say this first question is courtesy of Luke on Twitter at Rabid Lampshade. We thank you for the question. So we will get this going here. And best of luck to you. And good luck. We're just milking this out for full suspense. Here we go. All right.
Thank you.
How many matches has Mr. McMahon wrestled at WrestleMania?
3.
True or false? The only WrestleMania in which the Bella Twins competed as a unit was WrestleMania 31.
True.
Who revealed the 24/7 championship?
Mick Foley.
What year was the first WWE Backlash pay-per-view?
2001.
What color was Ultimate Warrior's Intercontinental Championship at WrestleMania 6?
Black.
That did not. Final tally is 2 correct answers, which means that you won this lightning round. Congrats, HJZ.
Woo!
The head-to-head specific topic is the European Championship.
Ah!
Oh!
Okay.
Okay. All right, gentlemen, are you ready? HJZ, you will be going first.
Okay.
Who was the inaugural European champion?
Would that be, I want to say, D'Lo Brown?
That is incorrect. British Bulldog defeated Owen Hart in the tournament finals. Okay, you still have that lead, that advantage. buzzer to you. Who is the only person to hold the European and WWE championships at the same time?
Shawn Michaels.
That is correct. Had the WWE championship, British Bulldog for that European title. So there we go, 1-1 at this point. HJZ, back to you. True or false, Kurt Angle held the European championship?
True.
That is correct. Oof. All right, so you got your lead back there. Mike, okay. Over to you now. Jeff Jarrett is the only superstar to hold the European and Intercontinental championships at the same time.
False.
That is correct. Kurt Angle did it as well. So we are even now at two.
This is tense.
HJZ, back to you here. Which two superstars hold the record for most European championships at four?
I'm going to go with... this is honestly going to have to be a guess. I'm going to go with... I want to say... William Regal and British Bulldog.
So close. William Regal was correct. The other answer was D'Lo Brown, in my opinion, the greatest European champion of all time. So you don't get that one. We remain tied at two.
Boy.
Mike, you have three to go. Here we go, Mike, with your third question. Who are the only two superstars to become European champion without winning the title in a match?
Mark Henry. Midian.
That is correct. Mark Henry was given the European championship after Jeff Jarrett was able to get some help from him, and Midian found it in a bag. Mike, you have now taken the lead. 3-2. You each have two questions remaining. HJZ, back to you as the tide has turned. Here we go. Who was the first ever two-time European champion?
Would that be, I want to say British Bulldog.
That is incorrect. The answer is Triple H. Mike, okay. If you get this correct, you win.
Kayla, I'm sweating.
Here we go.
You're sweating.
Here we go. Mike,
yeah,
buzzer.
Exactly. We're sweating.
All right, here we go, guys. Mike, this is for the win. Who did Shane McMahon lose the European Championship to?
X-Pac?
No, that is incorrect.
That's where I got it
from. He never lost the European Championship. He retired as champion. Okay, so this is the final round. We have HJZ, you have to get this right to continue.
Okay.
Here we go. The European Championship has changed hands at how many WrestleManias?
Going to go with... I want to say, three times.
Say that again, sorry.
Sorry, yeah, I'm gonna go with three times.
That is incorrect.
Aww,
the answer was two. Mike Buzzard, you have done it. Congratulations. What a comeback there. Did not have
great
the advantage
job,
in the head-to-head round. Is able to come all the way back. Mike Buzzer, congrats.
True or false, The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin are the only ones to compete in the three-on-three, one-on-one matches against each other at WrestleMania?
False.
Who did Stephanie McMahon defeat to win her sole women's championship?
Jacqueline.
Who did The Undertaker defeat at SummerSlam 1994?
The Undertaker.
Who was the sole survivor in the main event of Survivor Series 1987?
Andre the Giant.
Who was the first person to lose the Money in the Bank contract to another superstar?
Ken Kennedy.
Ooh. Ooh. Wow. K-Zone flamethrower, wow. Baby.
That is impressive.
Wow.
Yeah. That is incredibly impressive.
I was hoping for six, but five will do.
Way to go.
Woo. That was not easy. All right. Just the first round here. There's still a lot of room to go no matter what happens in the lightning round. Adam, we're going to kick it over to you. We're going to put 30 seconds back on the clock. Remember, the clock will not start until I complete the first question, and we will get going here in just a second. We're wishing you a lot of luck, a lofty first score, but again, a lot of time here left to go no matter what happens. So here we go. Clock will begin at the completion of the first question. We wish you a lot of luck. Here we go. True or false? Shane McMahon is undefeated at SummerSlam.
False.
What city was WrestleMania 6 held?
Pass.
Who won the WWE Championship at Survivor Series 1994?
Hulk Hogan.
What year did Mick Foley compete as the Three Faces of Foley in the Royal Rumble match?
2001.
Who was the first ever SmackDown draft pick?
The Rock.
Which superstar ended Trish Stratus' first reign as women's champion? All right, your final score there was 2, which means that K-Zone is the victor of the first round, but again, that just gives him the advantage heading into the second round here. Matt, take it away.
Well, K-Zone's got the advantage heading into our head-to-head round, and I will tell you, this round will be all about King of the Ring. K-Zone, you take the advantage, and you will start. Are you ready?
In the zone, baby. Let's do
okay,
it.
Okay, here we go. Your first question. Who won the last King of the Ring tournament?
Baron Corbin.
That is correct. He'd be mad that you didn't call him King Baron Corbin, but you got it correct.
Still counts.
There you go. That's good to go. Adam, over to you. True or false, The Rock is a former King of the Ring?
False.
False. That is correct. He lost to Ken Shamrock in the finals of the 1998 King of the Ring. K-Zone, back to you. True or false, Kurt Angle is a 2-time King of the Ring?
False.
That is correct. Woo. Nearly pulled it off. Lost to Edge, though. I was at that show, believe it or not. Adam, back over to you. How many times has Jerry Lawler won the King of the Ring tournament?
Twice.
That is incorrect. Despite his name, he never won a King of the Ring tournament. Okay. This goes back over for the win here, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, to the K-Zone. Wow. Could get the 4. I take that back. No, we can still tie at 4. I take that back. So, still important. K-Zone, who did Mabel beat to win the 1995 King of the Ring?
Savio Vega.
That is correct, which also gave us Sir Mo, which is even better. Okay, now, Adam, this is to you. You must get this correct to continue this round.
Good luck, Adam.
Who is the only superstar to win a King of the Ring tournament and the Universal Championship?
Kevin Owens?
That is incorrect. The answer is Brock Lesnar won the 2002 King of the Ring. K-Zone, you are the victor with a perfect second round.
Perfect.
Congratulations. Oh, those are the brackets. Which one of these four gentlemen is going to get their chance at the great Mike Brown and his posse? That is what is coming up today. Scott Gatta, Jordan Rivera, Mike Buzzard, K-Zone.
Scott, the first question is going to come from someone very special, and then we're off to the races, brother. So are you ready to go?
Hey, guys, I have a question for you. Who was the first superstar to become WWE champion in England?
AJ Styles.
The first 2 Survivor Series pay-per-views were held in which state?
Illinois.
Who did Shawn Michaels forfeit the Intercontinental title to at In Your House 4?
Dean Douglas.
What year was the first WWE Fastlane event?
2015.
Who was the guest referee in the Bret Hart versus Yokozuna WWE Championship
Roddy
match at
Piper.
WrestleMania 10? Who did Cesaro beat? Who did Cesaro defeat to win his first United States
Santino
Championship?
Morella.
How many traditional singles matches took place at WrestleMania 2? Oh! Wow!
Nice
got
job!
Him, baby.
Way to go!
Got him, baby!
Strong first round score. That is strong. All right, Jordan, we're going to kick it over to you.
Yes, sir.
And same setup. We'll have a very special guest intro your first question, and then 5 is the score to beat. Now, remember, this is just the first round. Regardless of what happens here, we'll kick it over in the second round where, you know, the advantage is at stake, but still everything is up in the grabs. Wishing you a ton of luck. The clock will begin after the special guest concludes his first question, and we can kick that over to it now as long as you are ready. You ready?
Okay.
All right, let's do it.
Here's it to you. Which superstars competed for the WWE title at WWE No Mercy in 2000?
Kurt Angle and The Rock.
Managed by Johnny Valiant, what was the team of Brutus Beefcake and Greg Valentine called?
Pass.
Who competed in 2 different WWE Championship matches at the same WrestleMania and did it twice?
Daniel Bryan.
Who was the only, who won the only Good Housekeeping match in WWE history?
Goldust.
What was the main event of WWE Clash of Champions 2016?
Roman Reigns versus Brock Lesnar.
Which new team won the WWE? Okay, out of time.
Yeah, that was bad.
Your final tally on that is 1. But Jordan, just the first round. Plenty of room to go here. Matt, we'll kick it over to you.
Indeed.
All right, guys. So we know after that opening round that Scott will take the advantage into our head-to-head round number 2. The secret, special, specific round 2 topic is NXT.
Ooh.
Let's go.
You do not get to win that championship, though. However, we are going to get into that right now. And Scott, you have the advantage. So you will go first. As we get over to Scott. Are you ready, Scott?
I'm ready.
Here we go. Your first question. Name one of the 3 superstars who were in both the 2015 and 2021 Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic.
Roderick Strong. That's not right.
That is incorrect. One of the 3 would have been Johnny Gargano, Tyler Breeze, or Tommaso Ciampa. Still hold the 1-0 lead. Jordan, this is over to you.
Okay.
Which NXT takeover came first? Unstoppable, or Evolution, or Respect?
Respect. It's Unstoppable.
That is incorrect. The answer was R Evolution. The debut of Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn winning the NXT Championship. Okay. So you each get 1 wrong there. Scott holds the advantage. Back, Scott, to you. In which country did Finn Balor win his first NXT Championship?
Japan.
That is correct. Defeated Kevin Owens at Beast in the East on July 4th. You hold a 2-0 lead. Jordan, back over to you. Who did the Ascension defeat at NXT Arrival?
Gable and Jason Jordan.
That is incorrect. It is Too Cool, Scotty Too Hottie, and Grandmaster Sexay. Scott, we go over to you with a 2-0 lead. Adam Cole was the first NXT North American champion. Who was the second NXT North American champion?
Ricochet.
That is correct. And a 3-0 lead, which means, Jordan, you have to get this right to continue.
Okay.
Here we go. To stay alive, who was the only team to voluntarily relinquish the NXT Tag Team Championship?
Tommaso Ciampa and Gargano.
Unfortunately, that is incorrect. It was the Viking Raiders, and that means Scott Gatto, with a score of 3-0, will move on to the Stump the Bump Finals.
Big Papa Bump!
Scott, congratulations.
This matchup, this is marquee. I waited for this all week. This is spectacular. This is the semifinals.
How many times has a superstar defended the WWE Championship in their first WrestleMania match?
Three.
How many people have held the NXT Championship multiple times?
Three.
Kane held the WWE Championship for only one day. What type of match did he defeat Stone Cold in to become champion?
First Blood.
Bret Hart wrestled how many matches in one night in 1993 King of the Ring?
Four.
Boyz II Men sang America the Beautiful at which WrestleMania?
15.
What football star provided? All right. Woo!
Nice job. Four's a real good number.
Mr. Buzzard.
Well, I'll take it.
Nice job, Mike.
Oh, I'll say.
Way to go, Mike. Way to go.
Oh, this is spicy, K-Zone. This is spicy, baby. Good.
Buzzard, you got the WrestleMania 15 Boyz II Men question. You're A-OK in my book. but, all right, K-Zone.
He's very happy about that.
Yeah, that was mine. All right, K-Zone, you know the drill. You know, lightning round here. You know, just it's for the advantage. Much like with Buzzard, we'll have a special guest intro your first question. At the completion of that first question, the clock will begin, and then we'll get into it from there. Are you ready?
In the zone, baby.
All right. Let's start with the question.
Here's a brain buster for you. Who are the winners of the first season of Tough Enough in 2001?
Maven and Nydia.
What 90s child star did Bob Backlund play in chess at WrestleMania 11?
Jonathan Taylor Thomas.
The 1993 Survivor Series team known as the All-Americans featured Lex Luger, The Undertaker, and
Steiner
which tag
Brothers.
Team? What was the main event of WWE TLC 2012?
Pass.
Who was the last WWE Hardcore Champion?
Rob Van Dam.
Hulk Hogan's only tag team championship reign was with which superstar?
Edge.
How much money did Andre the Giant win for slamming Big John?
$15,000.
Getting the tally here. Five for K-Zone. Wow. Five, which gives K-Zone the lightning round victory heading into the second round. Matt, as always, we'll throw it over to you.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
As competitive as we hoped it to be, everybody.
This is fun.
All right, so we will head into round two with K-Zone having the advantage. We, in the head-to-head round, will be talking about WrestleMania of the 2000s. These are WrestleMania questions of the 2000s. So here we go. K-Zone, you're up first with the lead. Are you ready?
You know what I'm going to say.
Okay.
He's in the zone, baby.
He's in the zone.
I'm giving you a chance to say your catchphrase on WWE television. So here we go. You are ready.
In the zone, baby.
Thank you very much. All right, here we go. Your first question. Name the two WrestleManias that Motorhead performed at.
17. And
need an answer.
19. No, it's not 19. 21.
That is incorrect. And you made your own correction there. 17 and 21. No point there. You do still hold your lead. Mike Buzzard, this is your question. Who did Edge beat in his first WrestleMania singles match?
Booker T.
That is correct.
1-1, baby.
Woo! Two men who really worried about Japanese shampoo. Okay, over to the K-Zone. We are tied at one. How many times have tag team champions faced each other in a singles match at WrestleMania?
I believe it's twice.
That is correct. Eddie Guerrero versus Rey Mysterio and John Cena versus Shawn Michaels. K-Zone takes the lead back. Mike Buzzard, this is for you. Name the two non-WWE superstars Big Show has faced in one-on-one competition at WrestleMania.
Floyd Mayweather and, unfortunately, we had to see against Akebono.
That is correct. Unbelievable disrespect for Akebono. Not necessary there. But we are tied at two. Okay.
Just the attire. Just
all right,
the attire.
Fair enough, Mike. We won't make you wear that. Back over to K-Zone. We are tied at two. Who won the only one-on-one match at WrestleMania 2000?
Terry Runnels.
That is correct.
Wow.
Wow.
At 3-2. You are back up. We go back to Mike Buzzer trying to tie it at three. Mike, name the four members of the New Breed who faced the ECW Originals at WrestleMania 23.
Kevin Thorne, Bonnie Brown. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Marcus Corvon, Matt Stryker, and Elijah Burke.
That is correct. Nice adjustment there. Marcus Corvon, Kevin Thorne, Elijah Burke, and Matt Stryker. We're tied at three.
Lord, have mercy.
Woo! Wow. Tied at three. You each have two questions remaining in the head-to-head round. Back over to the K-Zone. At WrestleMania 2000, how many times did the hardcore title change hands in the Hardcore Championship Battle Royal?
Six.
That is incorrect. The answer is 10. Mike, much like last week, you have a chance to now come back and take the lead. Here we go. At which WrestleMania did Great Khali make his WrestleMania debut?
WrestleMania 23.
That is correct. And you have taken the lead. Perfect in this round. He beat Kane. K-Zone, you need this to stay alive. Here we go. Ric Flair competed in what type of match at WrestleMania 22?
Money in the Bank.
That is correct. We are now tied at four. Mike, if you get this right, you move to the finals. If not, we will go to a tiebreaker. Here we go. Mike for the win. How many times did The Rock hit the rock bottom on Stone Cold Steve Austin at WrestleMania 19?
I'm gonna go with my gut right at the top. He hit him with three.
Mike? Congratulations, you have just won with a perfect head-to-head round. What an absolute showdown. Mike Buzzard defeats the K-Zone to move on to the finals.
This is a massive, massive matchup in the finals. Mike Brown, though, has made his prediction. Mike Brown has put his prediction on Twitter. Here it is. He's got a Mike B versus Mike B clash in the finals.
I got good news. I just got promoted. That's right, around here, they now call me Captain Mike, which got me thinking, maybe you should call me Captain Comeback.
I didn't make it this far to only make it this far, and I will close the book on Captain Comeback.
All right, here's a thinker. Which WWE Hall of Famer had his only match at the 2001 Royal Rumble pay-per-view?
Drew Carey.
All right, they're the only team to win the NXT Tag Team titles in a ladder match?
Street Profits.
Who was Kane's first pay-per-view opponent after he debuted at Bad Blood 1997?
Mankind.
At WrestleMania 2, Roddy Piper got himself disqualified in his boxing match with Mr. T in which round?
Round 2.
Including WrestleMania 37, how many times has WrestleMania been held in the state
Five.
Of Florida? Who was the final?
Wow.
All right, let's see.
Nice job.
That's a good score right there.
Four correct.
Nice job.
That's a good score right there. Well done.
All right, that's really solid. Mike Brown should be worried. Mike Buzzard, you should be worried. That is a really solid number.
All right. Mike Buzzard, we're throwing it to you. Now, same deal. We'll have a special video message. The clock will begin at the completion of that video message, and then we'll get into everything from there. Xavier Woods providing the video question. You feeling good? You ready to go?
Let's do this.
All right, let's throw it to Woods.
Hey, yeah!
there's a man that I'm gonna ask you about. They say when this man does push-ups, how many does he do? He does all of them. A man who, when he does push-ups, he does not push himself up, but he pushes the earth down. What year did Chuck Norris show up at Survivor Series? The floor is yours. Answer this question, if you dare.
1994.
Who did Roman Reigns pin to earn the Shield's first pay-per-view win?
Daniel Bryan.
What venue was the host for the first WCW Monday Nitro?
The Mall of America.
How many Money in the Bank ladder matches took place at WrestleMania?
5.
Who won the Intercontinental Championship at WrestleMania 18?
RVD.
What was the official team name of Diesel, Shawn Michaels, Owen Hart, Jim Neidhart, and Jeff Jarrett at Survivor Series 94?
Pass.
Name the three supers. We did not get that last one in. We have a tie.
Wow.
First tie of the entire tournament.
I got the tiebreaker, if that helps here. Okay.
Yes.
Gentlemen, you know you now need your pen and paper because we need the number here. The number is the thing. And by the way, when you write it down, wait, because we'll have you both reveal at the same time. Are you both ready?
Ready.
Let's do this.
Okay, so write it and hold it, and then I will tell you to hold them up. Here is your tiebreaker question. In seconds, from bell to bell, how long was the main event of WrestleMania 35? Just write it down for now. Let me know when you're ready. Buzzard is ready. Scott, are you ready? And
ready.
Let's show it right now.
Sorry. It fell.
That's all right. Buzzard, bring him into... Okay, both show right now. Bring it down, Mike.
All right,
let's read these. 1736 for Buzzard. 1331 for Gata. And the answer is 1287. That will give Scott Gata the advantage heading into the next round.
Both of you were so close. I would have put, like... some crazy number like 7 million or something.
So close. All right. So after the tiebreaker, Scott gets it. That brings us to the shootout round. Before we get to the category, let's go to Mike Brown. Mike, what did you think of that first round?
I thought they did pretty good. I mean, Mike Buzzard, it was the Teamsters, right? At Survivor Series 94.
You are correct, sir. Yes. Right. Yes, you are.
So, yeah. So. I don't know. We'll see what happens.
Just showing off a bit. All right.
Wow.
So, as we have been doing, it is a specific category for our head-to-head round. And, gentlemen, the specific category is In Your House. How apropos this time of year. Your House. And... Scott, with the advantage, you will get the first question. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, as your shirt might note, here is your first question. At which In Your House event did Bret Hart and Diesel face off in a steel cage?
In Your House 6, Rage in the Cage.
That is correct. By the way, if any of these come up, we will take the number or the title of the In Your House. Scott, you gave us all of it, and you have that one correct. So you're up 2-0, and we go to Mike. Mike, Jeff Jarrett performs with My Baby Tonight at In Your House 2. Who was his opponent on that night?
Razor Ramon.
That is incorrect. He faced and lost to Shawn Michaels, where Shawn became the new Intercontinental Champion. So we go back to Scott, who now has the 2-0 lead. Scott, at No Way Out of Texas In Your House, who was Shawn Michaels' last-minute replacement in the main event?
Savio Vega.
Recent bump guest Savio Vega is correct. And you now go up 3-0.
Wow.
Nice job. Mike, back over to you, down 3-0. At which In Your House did Psycho Sid defeat Vader to become the number one contender for the WWE Championship at the Survivor Series. Need an answer.
The year and the month. 17.
That is incorrect. It's In Your House 11, Buried Alive. So that brings us back to Scott, who can win the whole thing here and would advance, obviously, to Mike Brown. But first, he has to get this correct. Scott, here we go. Bret Hart wrestled which two superstars at the first In Your House?
Hakushi and Jerry Lawler.
Scott, that is correct.
Wow.
Congratulations to Scott Gatta, a perfect head-to-head round, and he will move on to Mike Brown.
Scott Gatta is our 2021 Stump the Bump champion. But let's rewind a bit and see how he got here. Last year, Scott submitted a video to be in the tournament that his current opponent won with ease.
And I am officially entering WWE's The Bump WrestleMania contest.
All right, Mike Brown, where you at, buddy?
What's going on, guys?
Congratulations!
He even submitted a question in our Stump the Bump cast segment last February, which the cast correctly answered.
Randy, the answer is Sheamus.
Good job, Camper.
His tenacity paid off, and Scott not only was entered into this year's tournament, but he impressed with his vast knowledge all the way through.
Who holds the record for most appearances in the Royal Rumble match?
Kane.
In which country did Finn Balor win his first NXT championship?
Japan.
Who was Shawn Michaels' last-minute replacement in the main event?
Savio Vega.
He's been waiting a long time for this, but will Scott's determination pay off? Can he take down the man who took home the gold last year? We're about to find out.
The hype is real.
Big Papa Bump!
The hype is real.
That's right. This is Boss. This is Thrasher. We're the Headbangers. And you're watching Stump the Bump. But I'll tell you what, there's
Wait,
only...
Isn't a stump really a little bump?
I don't know. We're talking about a contest here.
Oh, that's right.
On WWE Network.
Right, we're talking about Scott. Scott's the one who's going to win it all. Because Mike Brown, the weather clown,
is talking too much trash
about Scott.
So let me tell you something right here, Mike. This is the real champion right here. He's going to take your title, and he's going to take it whenever he wants.
I'm out here staying in peak cardiovascular shape to defend Mike Brown going into the Stump the Bump contest grand finale. And you've got Scott Big Bucks Gatta over here paying off legendary tag team, the Headbangers, to cut his promos for him. Scotty, cat got your tongue, buddy?
Ding dong, hello. Hey, Scott, I have a question for you. What pay-per-view event did I debut? Huh? What is it, huh? What is it, huh? Better not get it wrong, Scott. Don't get it wrong, Scott. Don't get it wrong.
Scott.
Battleground 2016.
Which tag team did Mr. McMahon and Shane McMahon defeat at Backlash 2006?
Shawn Michaels and God.
Who won the second ever WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal?
Naomi.
Name the four superstars who have won the WWE Championship in an Iron Man match.
Shawn Michaels, Triple H. A pass. I guess, oh, that was terrible.
All right, you got two correct.
Oh, boy.
Two correct. That's okay. That does not take you out of this, as you know.
Tough round there. All right, Mike, we will throw it over to you. It will be the same exact setup. We will start with a special video question from a superstar. At the completion of that question, the timer will begin. We will ask the rest of the lightning round questions. Remember, the winner here gets the advantage heading into the shootout round. Mike Brown, 2020 champion, are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
All right, we will throw it to our special video message.
Hey, Mike, congratulations on making it to the finals. I have a question for you. Because you're in the finals, there's a question involved. You get it, right? Okay. Here's the question. What year did Kurt Angle and Rey Mysterio face each other in the opening match of SummerSlam, one of the greatest opening matches in history of any show, in my opinion? But specifically, this happened at a SummerSlam. What year, Mike? Answer me!
2002.
Who was forced to wear a diaper after losing a crybaby match at In Your House 6?
1-2-3 Kid.
Who was the first women's Grand Slam champion?
Charlotte.
From first to last in order, list the members of Evolution that Undertaker defeated at WrestleMania.
Triple H, Ric Flair, Randy Orton, Batista.
Who was the first person to pin Brock Lesnar in a match?
Big Show.
Who did The Undertaker defeat in the first main event of Raw?
Damien Demento.
All right, getting the tally now. Final score of 4, which gives you the advantage heading in to the shootout round. Congrats, Mike. And Matt, I will throw it over to you.
All right, so last year's champ has the advantage heading in to our head-to-head round. But what will we be talking about? That's the big question, right? I'm wearing my WCW Nitro jacket. There are 3 important letters in the history of wrestling. N-W-O. But today, that does not stand for the New World Order. No. Today, that stands for No Way Out.
Ooh,
we will be talking questions about No Way Out. And Mike, with the advantage, you will go first. Are we ready?
All right, let's do this.
Mike, with the advantage, here is your first question. What years and how many No Way Out events were SmackDown brand specific shows?
So five of them?
Is incorrect. The answer is 4. 2004 to 2007. Of course, that first one in the Cow Palace, Eddie Guerrero defeating Brock Lesnar. You still hold the advantage, but do not get your first question right. So, Scott, you now have a chance to tie. Here's your first question. Scott, what city is the only place to hold No Way Out multiple times?
Las Vegas.
We are tied at 1.
Wow.
Las Vegas hosted in 2001 and 2008.
Breathe,
so we're tied at 1.
Wow! That's incredible.
Which, by the way, we're pretty much dead even now. The advantage is gone. Mike, back to you. Mike, what match featured the only title change at No Way Out 2003?
It's a tough one. I'm going to say tag team title.
That is incorrect. It was Matt Hardy winning the Cruiserweight Championship over Billy Kidman, Lance Storm, William Regal defending their world tag team titles that night. And Triple H defeated Scott Steiner. No math needed for this one. It's 1-1. Scott, back over to you to take the lead. Name 5 of the 9 competitors in the Cruiserweight Open for the title at No Way Out 2006.
Gregory Helms. Jamie Noble. Billy Kidman. Shannon Moore. And Jimmy Wang Yang.
Incorrect. 5 of the 9. Gregory Helms was correct. Brian Kendrick, Funaki, Kid Cash, Nunzio, Paul London, Psychosis, Scotty Tuhati, and Super Crazy. So we remain tied at 1. Mike, back over to you. Name 5 of the 8 competitors in the Cruiserweight Open for the title at No Way Out 2007.
2007. It's like the very end of the Cruiserweight title too, so it's kind of rough. Chavo, Paul London. Shannon Moore. Nunzio. Jimmy Wang Yang.
Incorrect. Chavo, Daivari, Funaki, Gregory Helms, Jamie Noble, Jimmy Wang Yang, Scotty Tuhati, and Shannon Moore. You guys are still tied at one.
I'm getting nervous.
Very hard category.
These are really hard.
Yes. Welcome to the Grand Championship, everybody. All right, Scott, another chance to take the lead. What was the stipulation for the main event of No Way Out 2005?
Barbed wire steel cage.
That is correct, and Scott has taken the lead. JBL retained in that matchup. Scott, you have the lead. Mike, back to you. Name the only tag team to lose a tag team title match at consecutive No Way Out events.
This is just a guess, but hold on. Wait 1 second.
Answer, Mike.
I know. Eminem.
That is incorrect. The answer is the Basham Brothers, lost in 2004 and 2005. Which means, Scott, if you get this correct, you will be our ultimate Stump the Bump champion. Are you ready, Scott?
Pressure's on. I'm ready, though.
Here we go. For the win, how many teams did APA eliminate on their way to winning the tag team turmoil match at No Way Out 2002?
I'm going to say they eliminated 3 teams.
The APA eliminated Billy and Chuck and no one else. That is incorrect.
Man.
We go to the final question potentially here. Mike, you need this to stay alive. To remain in the game. Mike, who did Ric Flair defeat in a career-threatening match at No Way Out 2008?
Was it MVP?
The answer is Mr. Kennedy. Scott Gatta is the new Stump the Bump Ultimate Champion. Congratulations to both of you. Congrats, though, to Scott. You have pulled it off. Tried to get in this last year, did not get in, came through the tournament. You win the whole thing. You defeat Mike Brown. Congratulations.
Scott Gatta, congratulations, dude. Simply amazing. You did it in the 2021 Stump the Bump Trivia Contest. Truly impressive victory, my man. You, of course, are going to get a signature title belt from HBK himself. And the showstopper has got to sign it.
Scott, that's there you go,
awesome.
Man.
That's awesome. I can't thank you guys enough. That's awesome.
Congrats, man.
Congratulations. It's been a lot of fun having both of you guys with us, obviously all last month or so. But, Scott, very impressive to come out of this tournament. I'm sure you're now the man to beat all over the world.
I guess. I owe you guys all the credit, though. Can't all thank you guys enough.
You got it, man. Congratulations.
Right. Las Vegas.
Well, that was a fun one.
Bump!
Wow. Congrats to Scott Goddard. Las Vegas is incredible.
Are you kidding me?
What an answer. How did you
put that out? That's the decider. You got Vegas right, baby.
I love that.